Hey guys, my name is David Odili. This channel is about graphic design, multimedia, blogs, and the rest, as the case may be. So today we are going to be designing a Valentine flyer, Valentine poster that you can post on social media, or you can print. And it's very simple for you to do. We need to do follow the instructions. So if you're new to the channel, please subscribe. If you're new to the channel, hit that subscribe button and turn on the notification button for you to get updated whenever I post a new video. So thanks, and let's get into the business of today. So we are here to start designing. So what are we going to be doing? We're going to be designing this Valentine flyer here. This Valentine flyer that you've seen in the you have seen it in the thumbnail. So first of all, we click on create new, or you can click control new, control n. In case you can see what I'm doing is on the screen. So what I normally use is 4 by 4 inches and 300 resolution RGB. If you're following the channel, you know that's what I normally use. So click on create, then this is normally here, control plus zero to show you the full document, show you the full size view, or to fit to screen, as the case may be, to fit to screen. So we're going to remove these guides here. We'll clear the guides. Then we're going to start with our colors here. These are files we're going to use to design. They are in the link in the description below. So I think I created artboard by mistake, so but doesn't matter. Just leave that. The first of all, what the first thing we do, we're going to create an adjustment layer. Click on this adjustment layer here. I click on solid color. Then the solid color is the spec we're going to use, FA0550. That's the color we're going to use. Then we're going to bring in. We're going to add an effect to this. I'm going to double click on it. Double click on it two times, left click on it. Then I'm going to click on gradient overlay. So the gradient overlay, we're going to use it. I'm going to click on this basics here and get something like this. Create overlay, something like that. Then the scale will be about 100, the list will be about 90, and the opacity will be about 100%. Then do something normal, right? Okay. So I think this is going to be a radial style. Then what I'm going to click on is this. Then this is. The first one is here. It's going to add another color here. Color is FF003C, right? And the inner color, this one here, is going to be C30 53F. All right, that is just that about this one. I'm going to click OK and OK here. So what next we're going to do? Bring in a background here, a background from our this in here, this pink hard background here. Alright, go to drag it inside here, and drag it inside here. We can wait for it to load, it taking much time. Alright, just drag and drop, or you can do Ctrl P. Ctrl P means to place. I think I got that one. Control P means to paint. Yeah, put that one wrong. We need to put on control click, can you click on file, then click on it, please embed it. That is what I'm after. Please embed it. So go to our where it is, where the files are, then we place this on this. So then you drag and drop, we place. So on this one, I'm going to change the blending mode to dissolve. I want to change the opacity to 3%. 3%, exactly 3%. Alright, 3%. Yes. Then I want to bring in another shape, another object, another background. And this is this one here. I'll just drag. I want to drop inside here. Alright. Inside here. Then I want to scale this to proportionally to cover the full canvas. Alright. And click on this code here or enter. You press Ctrl 0 to see your full document, to see your actual size of your document. Okay. Scale mode. So this is it. Just drag it and make sure that it's well proportionally scaled from the document. Alright. I'm going to change the blending mode of this. Select this one. Change the blending mode to overlay. I'm going to change the opacity to 24%. 24% here. Or 26 is, you can go with that. For what next are we going to do? I'm going to bring in another object. I'm going to lock this one here. Lock this one here. So that makes our background. So meanwhile, I'm going to create a new shape. A new shape layer. Click on rectangle to U. And we can change this rectangle to ellipse to ellipse to here. And we'll draw the ellipse here. Hold control and we hold shift. Hold shift so that it can be proportionally scaled. You can see 450 by 450 pixels. So scale it proportionally. Right. Alright, remember Ctrl 0, and we're going to bring it here. Then we're going to click on this place here. We change the color to white. Then, or if we can't do that, we can just click on here and click here, fill color. Then we'll change it to white. Here, white. All those waves, we can use them. So, what we do here, we're going to place on Ctrl T. Ctrl T to transform. Then I'm going to transform. I'm going to click on wrap. So this wrap tool, I'm going to use it to make a shape like a heart shape. Like here, it's a heart shape here. Is it not? It's a heart shape. Alright. I'm going to use this wrap tool here. With a heart shape. The heart kind of shape here. I'm going to click on Ctrl T again. Then you right click on it and click on wrap. So drag this one down. I want to do just pick this one like this. Pull this one out of this. Right. Then. Alright. I've changed that to. I've changed the mode to that. Alright, so I'm going to change that to this. So it's a heart shaped like that. So we're going to scale it a bit. Then we'll transform it. Wrap. Remember the wrap that we did before? It's not that perfect. Make the heart shape that. Alright. Then we scale this up. Wrap. This is quite bigger than that. Alright. Okay. So that is that. I think I made a mistake here. Say, Ctrl T, Ctrl T, click on wrap, and we'll drag this down, down, down. It's already down. Make sure this one is a bit better than that. Okay, on the same level, All right, heart shape. All right, we drag this one out. Drag this one out. Okay. With the heart shape like this. Yeah, I need to. Yeah. All right. So we're going to change the color of the shape to something less white. It's not really white, but the color I use is this. Alright, this is the color FV5EP, right? So what we're going to do next is we're going to bring in our image, one of our image. I'm going to bring in one of our image, and I'm going to need in Illustrator for this image. So we're going to click right click on this zip folder. This contains Illustrator documents including my recent designs, extracted after extracted this whole folder. Then when you open the folder, you see these documents. What we need is this heart here. We need this heart here. So what we do is that we're going to open this document in Illustrator, this EPS, for the initial file. But as it's opening, let's give you many stuff here. So I'm going to create Valentine or text. Let's text Valentine. So the font I use is disclaimer plain, and it is in 100 pixels. I used 100 pixels. All right. So I'm gonna change this to all small letters. Valentine's, right, correct. All right, this is Valentine. Then happy. I'm gonna change the font to Amelia. All right, and the size is 18. So this one is just here. Then I'll duplicate this one. Ctrl J to duplicate it. And now I'll type A here. Alright. Times B. Alright. So what are we gonna do? We're gonna bring in this file. I'll open our Illustrator. We'll click close. We're gonna close this because I don't have the phones are here. Ctrl 0. To see everything in this file. So what I'm going to do now, well, we just need this heart here. So in this point of view, we're going to open our layers panel, our layers here. I'm going to sort out the layers to look for the object we're looking for. All right, we know it's in this place on the search, and here it is. So I'm just going to click on it here, and I'm going to drag it into Photoshop. Okay, good. So I'm going to wait for it to load. It's loaded already. You can see it's loaded already. Good. Yeah, very nice. So what we're going to do now, we're going to bring in our PNG, the image of the lovers inside there. Image of the lovers. I've already put them in PNG, so we don't have to cut them out again. So this is it. Click on good. We scale them down to proportion to meet the what we need. All right. System. And increase it a bit. Take it down. Increase it a bit. Alright. So. I think we'll take it down. Make it bigger. Bigger. So that just their head will be in focus. Alright. So this is good. Okay, so the next step. And for these ones, we can come down. Let's lock this one so that we won't get distracted by it. Okay. And we can take this one down just towards their head. If it be, we can move it to this side so I can see it here. And this here. So we're almost done with this. You can see it's very, very simple. Almost done with this. This. And I think we'll take this above the picture or take the picture below it. That comes out very well. Then what we're gonna do, we're going to bring this one up and this one here. Alright, take this one up. What we're gonna do, I'm gonna click on this. I'm gonna remove this and this. I'm gonna remove this and this. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna double click on this thumbnail here, or this smart object thumbnail. Then to open up in Illustrator. Then what we're going to do is select those ones, these ones here. And I'm just going to click on A, direct selection tool, and delete this one here. Say Ctrl S to save it. Let's use Ctrl S to save it. I'm going to get changes in Illustrator. So we can have this now in Illustrator. What to do? Come to Photoshop. And what to do? I'm going to duplicate this one. Ctrl J. Duplicate. Well, for now, what I'm going to do, I'm going to do transform on the T. So I'm going to change the Y axis side to minus. Sorry, the X axis. X width to minus here. So it comes the other way. Alright. I'm going to move this side. So in this stage, we're almost done with the design. And what else can we notice here? Alright. Almost done with this. Alright, let's add a little drop shadow to this. Add a little drop shadow. Alright, double drop shadow. Move this up. And begin here. Alright. Then this picture. I'm going to create this picture. I'm going to duplicate it. Ctrl G to duplicate it. Then we'll carry the copy under. Then we're going to go to image adjustments, go to hue and saturation. Then we'll take down the lightness down, and we'll take down the saturation down. Okay. And this is what you have. What you have here, dark picture. All right, very dark picture. Take it down. Okay, what are we going to do with that picture? We're going to change. I'm going to scale it up a bit. Move it to the side. I'm going to design a bit. Then I'm going to go to double click on this. This layer style. I'm going to click on color overlay. Color overlay is going to be white. White. Right. So that is how you create this design. It's very, very simple. So let's look at our main design and look at this one and compare. Compare and contrast. Let's release this circle. Alright. So, that's what we got. That's what we have here. And what we have here. So, thanks for watching this video. So, do well to subscribe, do well to like, and follow this channel for more things. Thank you very much. See you later. Thank you.